Thanks, Mavis. I'm going to give you an overview on home support, assisted living, and residential care. And my name is Paulona. I sit in the central intake office of Vancouver Coastal. Help people to know about the service and also help them to access services. So basically, there's three scenarios. The first one is your loved one has some acute situation and end up in the hospital. If you think that when a person is being discharged needs service, don't call us. Talk to the people in the hospital. Either talk to the nurse or the doctor. The doctor will actually refer the case to what we call a transitional service team, the TST team. They will actually arrange the service from the hospital. The second scenario is you're not being seen by a professional right now. It has no case manager. That would be the number to call. 604-263-7377. We have nurses on the call center to answer call, explain services, and help you to access the service. And the third scenario would be actually there's someone coming into the home to provide service, whereas that can be a nurse, a physiotherapist, or even a case manager. Then I would say that's the person to talk to with your needs and what you need. So that's basically, that's what's on the slide. So in terms of whether you're eligible for home support, it would be determined by the case manager.
Can you speak a little
more? Oh, I'm so sorry. So basically, whether the person is eligible for home support, it will be determined by the case manager when they come over to do the assessment. Now the thing is, before you call central intake, actually I have a card here. If you're anxious to know about the number, so you can pick one up for. This number is for Vancouver residents. If you have people that live in Richmond, Burnaby, North Vancouver, West Vancouver, they do have different numbers. And it's actually on here. You pick up one of these. Anybody need to know this intake from Burnaby? Because that's the phrase that helps, it's a different number. So the number is, let's see, 604-918-7447. And ask for the intake nurse. Now before you call, there's a few things that you need to collect before you call. Is the person that you're calling for the name on the care card, that's a legal name on the care card. And the person's birthday, care card number, address, and phone number. I mean, a lot of people will go to the loved one, but they don't know about the address. They can go there easily, but they don't know that. So we need to know the address. And also the doctor's name and phone number. And also an emergency contact person and a phone number. And when you call, please give yourself at least 20 to 30 minutes because we need to ask questions to actually know the information to facilitate the visit. So in center intake, we will actually arrange for a case manager to come and do a home visit. And during that time, the case manager will actually assess the person with standardized guidelines. That will also include a financial assessment. And in the previous slide, if you remember, it asks you to fill in the income tax. That's the thing that the case manager needs to see, is your income tax return to determine the eligibility and the amount that you need to pay. And before the case manager will do the assessment, the person must agree to the program, which means that you're being informed what is being done and you agree to it. And then after the interviews, or the home visit probably takes an hour and a half, depends on how complex it is. And the information will send to priority access. And there they will prioritize the cases and also put on wait list, depends on what is requested. And as you can see here, for assisted living, the waiting time varies from months to years, depends on which one you'd like to have. The popular ones has a longer waiting list, and then also popular one has a shorter one. And for residential care, it ranges from weeks to several months. And one thing that is very important is once you're on the wait list and the space comes up, for assisted living, the person basically needs to move in within 48 hours. So once you're on the list, you basically have to be ready to move. Or you say, oh, 48 hours is not enough, I need maybe one or two few days. you can't say that, oh, I'm more than this, I got this spot, I'm not ready now, I'll move in when I'm ready. It doesn't work that way. You don't move in, you'll be off the list. And you need to reapply again. And for residential care, it's even shorter. It's 24 to 48 hours. Ready to move. Or else you'll be again off the list and you need to reapply. It's not like you go down to the bottom, it's just off the list. You need to reapply again. So that's something to...
You know, you really need to project. Because it's just hard to hear you back. And I can do fine, but...
Well, this is the last one. So we have three resources for you. The first one is actually the Vancouver Coastal Health website. And they have search engines. So if you need to know more about assisted living, you type in the search engine, they will come up with the information. And the second one is the senior housing website. That website is a neat one. If you want to know the list of facilities, let's say assisted living public or assisted private, they have a search engine. Same thing, you basically go to the search engine and check off the things that you want and it'll give you a list of like private assisted living or residential care. So this is a very neat website to have. And the last one is the Ministry of Health. So basically you need to know about service about the ministry. You can put it to the search engine and get the information there. Okay.
Is there a website that will indicate the wait period?
Yeah. Not really, right?
No.
Yeah. Have to ask the case manager to come to assess. Yeah.
So and just to wrap it up, the one question that you did have, I actually did have it written down, I just didn't read it. So the maximum amount for residential care per month right now, and it does change because BIS changes and everything, but right now it's $3,022 a month for residential care. $3,022. And then just back to Colonna's point around wait lists and when you get the call, just to clarify, for assisted living, when you get the call, you may have been on the list for months or years, you actually have to accept the unit within 48 hours. That's saying, okay, I'm going to move in. But the move-in actually will happen after that.
Oh,
so it's
you
the
don't
accepted.
Have to
no, because it's, so I know it's different for residential care, but for assisted living, we know that actually many people are living in an apartment where they have to give notice because you can't afford to pay in two places at the same time. So we need you to move in as quickly as possible, but we would say you need to move in within a month, not more than 2 months, but because you need to wrap up your apartment, get rid of it, and move into your new apartment. But you have to say yes or no within 48 hours, and if you say, no, this just isn't the right time, you do start the process over. It's not that you can't, but something, you need to, you know, make sure that something changes if you're not ready right now, and you have to start the process over. So, yeah, so that's the end
that's
of our formal presentation.
This is not my area, but... So home support has changed over the years. 20 years ago, the world was quite a different place in terms of what services and tasks the home support workers were able to help people with. Over time, with looking at budgets and things, people have had to change the lists about what we think our healthcare dollars should be supporting and what they shouldn't be supporting and what other parts of the government should be supporting other parts. So generally speaking, the focus has been on personal care. Now, everything I'm gonna say it probably is better to have, if there's a big interest in like home support and getting more details, there is a manager that would be able to come back to talk about it specifically. But generally speaking, the focus has been on personal care. We know that in order to support
can
health.
Can you explain personal care?
Yes. Health is big. The word health includes your cooking, and it includes your house, and it includes, having safe clothes and safe rugs. Health is a really, really big thing, and cleaning of things. So, but personal care, when we talk about it, it's something that doesn't necessarily relate to your environment. It relates to you and your body. So it is things like helping with washing, helping with... basic hygiene every day, helping you with your medications. Medications is a huge, huge issue and causes huge amounts of illness in the community and emergency department stuff. So the focus in the last few years has been more on those types of tasks, which we know sometimes doesn't address the other bigger health issues, but there has been limitations from the home support services part believing that there's been changes in other sectors where, you know, there's more meal programs to address the cooking part and that sort of thing. All that to say, we're also in a shift right now because there's been a huge shift both in Fraser Health and in Vancouver Coastal Health in the last few months, and it's ramping up to say we need to support people at home more. So we need to actually have people go, when people are leaving the hospital, we're actually also trying to say, is there anything we can do to actually bring this person home first with extraordinary supports, knowing we probably can't do that forever, but if it's something that will work for a period of time to then keep you at home, we'll do that for a period of time to keep you at home. So this is all very new and very hot off the press in terms of trying to help people temporarily if we can shore them up and just kind of give a bit more support and then stabilize the situation. So there's a lot more of that intention, and there's a lot more people actually trying to do that at the moment. And so again, that, are we shifting back to where we were 20 or 30 years ago? No, and we probably never will. There will not be China being shined. There will not be windows being done. And I'm not being facetious. I know that there's lots and lots of other things about your environment that keep people safe and keep them at home. But again, we've been narrowing it down to just personal care provided by the health authority in the last few years. We're trying to now focus on transitions and supporting, you might need way more help during the transition. So that's a really big thing. So there's lots of words being bandied about that you might hear about, home is best, home first, huge amounts of care going in for home support. So as for studies, I'd have to defer to my colleagues about studies because I know they have been looking at them and they have been doing them. And I know sometimes the decisions are made that you kind of go, in the really, really big scheme of things, this is hard to make. And yet, you know, the health authority dollars are this big, and there are other pieces of the world as well that are accountable for other pieces of the world. So I'm not really saying much, but I am saying we're struggling with it.
Okay.
And it's changed a lot in the last few years. And if you want the home support folks to come back, I'd be happy to invite them.
Yes, and I'm just going to put in a plug for Jewish Family Service Agency again, because we have Laura Stannard on staff, who's our housing coordinator, and you can call in and sit down with her and talk to her about it, and she'll help you fill out applications as well.
Okay.